In this module, we're going to look at Microsoft Teams. So if we select that from the Microsoft Home, we can open it up in a web browser. If we just click through this quick tour, this is the main screen for Teams. So if we go to the Teams on the left-hand side and click on Create a Team, because this is an education-based tenant, you can see that we can set up teams for classes, professional learning communities, or a team used for staff members. So this is how an end user will create a team, but we need to look at the admin side. So if we go back to the main homepage and click on the admin to get to the admin console, and we go to active users, then we can see that we can license a user for teams. So if we edit the product license, so if you are licensed for the A5 faculty license, then you will have Teams installed. If we go to Settings, Services and Add-ins, one of the options is to configure Teams. As you can see, there are some tenant-wide settings. So in the General section, we can turn off the Skype for Business integration. In Email integration, we can allow users to send email to channels. And in the text box, we can put a list of allowed domains. So these domains will be allowed to email into channels. In the Apps section, we can allow or disallow applications that can be used within Teams, or we can allow sideloading of external applications. Further down, we can use settings by user or license type. So you can see that there are the faculty or the student license type. In the faculty one, we can then do some configuration around calls and meetings. We can configure whether they're allowed to use video. So we could turn the video off. So for instance, in a student one, once we've turned that license on, we can go down to calls and meetings, turn off video, or we can turn off scheduling and configure it for our specific students. In the messaging section, you can use a content rating on messages. So there are three options: allow all content, moderate, or strict. You may decide that the staff licensing allows for a moderate content rating or a strict one on students. We can also configure whether to allow or disallow memes or stickers and turn off other things like editing or deleting of their own messages. Once you've made your configuration changes, then all you need to do is click on Save. So these are the settings that you can configure on the admin side of Teams. If you actually want to know how to use Teams in a classroom, then one of the best options is to go to the Microsoft Education website, where there are a number of videos on how to use Teams in a classroom environment.